So this is it, Captain Blush. Salute quick. Yeah, what the dog is barking.
The dogs are barking. The snow is not falling. It's freezing outside.
The dogs are barking. The caravan is moving on, eh? And yes. It's time that we film another assembly of the planes.
Yes, this time we will assemble. And first, I will salute to all subscribers and viewers. Thanks for visiting our channel, for all your support, for spreading our passion.
For spreading your legs, no, of course. For spreading the passion from this channel. To the rest of the world. I mean, Captain Blush, this is the second filming and now we are more relaxed. I mean, the second filming of the assembly.
Hmm? Yes.
Now let's make this assembly good, interesting.
I won't be so stiff as the first time, but who knows?
I think that we all know the stiffler's mother, eh?
Yes.
Yeah, hey.
Now, what will we assemble? We will assemble Twin Otter 1.2 meter wingspan, which we have unboxed a few minutes ago. Well, to be exact, 8 minutes ago.
Yeah, but so, who cares about that, Captain Blush? Yo! No. We said that we would be short and you're looking at the clock, but what did they say?
No, I'm just looking when we were filming unboxing.
Yeah, not long ago, eh?
I will go per the manual as it says because it looks very easy and all I will need is...
Of course.
I have three different size screwdrivers, Phillips head, X-Acto knife and... bent or something crooked needle nose pliers.
Yeah, because viewers, the E-Flight is making the planes so easy to assemble that this is amazing. And the good thing is that later, of course, also they are easy to disassemble, to transport and to store. And that is what we love with these planes. And the quality is all around.
As Robert says, it can take from 3S from 2200 to 3200 milliamp.
Now, of course, today we will also set this plane on the radio. In this video, first Captain Blush will assemble the plane and later I will plug it in the radio and we will check how this plane works before we will take it to the runway.
And now we
yes, Captain Blush.
With model assembly. So, the first thing is to...
Well, show me the page because in fact we also will show you this. In
this
fact,
says this... about the plane and now yeah. You start with... landing gear, and now that is what we will do.
And this plane is so simple that you only have the two pages to assemble. But I will, you take start, Captain Blush, because this will be for later.
What?
Yeah, this is not now, you don't need this the floats.
This is for the floats. So, push rod, this bag of goodies is for the floats.
Yeah, of course, viewers, but today we will assemble it on the wheels.
We will not need this, so we have put that away.
So today we have the fuselage.
Yes.
We have the back of the plane, the horizontal stabilizer, which we have already put it here to the side, and you will have to put on the fins. Then we have the landing gear, you have the support for the wings, and you have the props, and that's it.
And if you're not sure how to install the props, there is actually a writing here, which has T7 blah 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 CR, and there is also on the prop.
You have these numbers
CR
here.
CR and C. So, CR is left, C is right.
So that's it.
Or vice versa.
So yeah, but usually they work to inside of the fuselage. They go inside, not outside.
So, the first thing first, I will unscrew this screw.
First, you will start with the landing gear.
Landing gear, yes. I will unscrew this screw, as it says in the manual. I will take this out, like this.
Put it to a side.
Put it to a side, yes. And now we will need...
This is this step, yours.
Yes. So, it goes to the backwards, like this. You put it inside, like this. Now, here is one support. Second and the third.
Now, of course, for that you will use
these
three plastic supports.
I will put them like this.
And do you know what I love, Captain Blush? On this E-Flight planes, that they have only one kind of bolts, and they are here. All around the plane, you have the same bolts, so you don't have to worry and check which bolts to put where. I mean, this is one thing that I really love with this plane, say.
Yes. Now we will. Take these bolts out, and I will take one by one with my this very crooked finger. Now I will start with one. Look, huh?
This is it, eh?
The first, how do you say? Finger tight or something like this. Not all.
Yeah, don't exaggerate, viewers, because you have here the wood.
No.
So maybe.
When you have two bolts inside, you go evenly down, so you don't mess the support like this. Okay, first one is done.
Now Captain Blush will put two more, and I will tell you in the meanwhile that in fact, if you will fly a lot, do check these bolts from time to time, because they are pushed inside the wood. So maybe sometimes if we want to tighten them really good and we don't want them to unscrew, we put a little CA glue inside.
Yes, but I wouldn't do this here.
Yeah, because you will disassemble this plane.
Yeah, because if you will fly with the floats, you need to take the bolts.
Yeah.
You can put small amount, let's say a half of a drop.
Yeah, but that is usually we put that later if we see that the bolts are getting looser more and more. And then if you want to secure them, we secure them in that way. But if you will tighten them good at this point, I don't think that they will unscrew later.
That's it. I have screwed in all three supports. Now,
and now
I will put this back in.
Like the cover this. Back, I mean, it fits perfect, huh, Captain Blush? Tell me, eh?
Yes.
Because viewers, you will see, and friends, when you will assemble yourself a plane, I mean, this is such a joy. Usually we put the music on, we take our time slowly and sexy, so you get familiar with the plane. But of course, today we want to show you how to do this, and now, Captain Blush, you will go to the front wheel, eh?
Yes, I will tilt.
You don't have to tilt nothing.
Towards me? Yeah, I have to.
Like this?
I have to unscrew this screw here.
And on the wheel, you have here, viewers, do you see this?
There's a small cut, a notch or something.
There
like
is
that.
A small cut, and here, the screw will
hold
this front wheel.
Front wheel.
Wheels, Captain Blush.
Like this. You just take a look.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I think that you will put it all the way down, and that's it, huh?
It should be right here.
Of course, tighten again with the feeling, and that's it. Eh?
Now, when you will put on the floats, you just unscrew the wheel off. You put here the push rod. It fits through here, all the way to the back to the float, and that's it.
Because I have seen on that picture that, in fact, if you have the floats on, you don't even have to disassemble the back wheels or something. They're on, eh?
I'm not sure about that.
But I won't say nothing, but hey.
I think
we will see that later.
You have to, because here is the same.
Yeah.
You have to disassemble the wheels, the back.
Sorry, viewers.
This is the same
as the wheels.
As the wheels.
The same shape as the wheels, of course.
Now, landing gear is done. Now we will go to
the back of the plane.
Yes, you just don't do it like that. I have done.
Now, of course, you must be careful here, because you already have the control horn installed, so that means that you can only push it inside from one side.
From one side, yes. Through the right side, like this, you push it in.
Yeah, but this fits perfect, huh?
Yes, now I will tilt it
around
here, and I will take a look, sneak peek, like this.
Because in fact, you have
holes
here
are
four holes.
Yes.
And in these holes goes the bolts, and that's it, eh?
Yes.
Isn't it magnetic?
No, it's not.
Yeah, but it should be.
Yeah, but it's not.
But it was.
Yeah. Right now, it's not.
Yeah, but where did the magnetism go, eh, Captain Blush?
Yeah, well, the magnetism is very interesting stuff.
You can do a lot of experiments with the magnets, eh? Huh?
Yes.
And if there weren't for magnets, we wouldn't have the motors.
No. Like this.
Look at this, eh?
Screw it a bit in, like halfway, and I will do the fourth one.
But like I have said in the previous video, Captain Blush and friends, this is so great. Because of this hobby, how much you learn. We have discovered in these 4 years so many planes that we didn't even know that they exist. I mean, this is amazing. And we still discover them every day.
Yes.
And I don't think that by the time that we will stop to film, I don't think that we will come to the end of the planes, huh, Captain Blush? Because there are so many that this is sick, eh?
Now, the next thing is I will
put
from here
this, you will...
I will put this to the lower one, and that's it.
And that's the only thing that you have to do, eh?
I usually put a zip tie on, or at least, or maybe I put on the glow planes, I put shrink tube.
Shrink tube on?
When all the plane is set up for you, you don't need to
Or maybe you can
nothing.
Just, yes, because by now, maybe, of course, we will see later when we will put the power on the plane, if this will be leveled like it should be, because usually at first I do trim the plane manually here, so I have all the trims left for the radio for later. And then you can put, maybe Captain Blush, you can cut a little hose from that. Did you have the hose for the fuel?
Fuel lines.
The fuel line, and you can put it here. You can put it here on this, a little 3-4 millimeters of the fuel line, and you put it on, so this doesn't come
silicone
apart.
Silicone tube.
Yeah, because usually, and many times, you already get that with the plane.
Yeah, you get it with the plane, and my friend, late friend Darko was using that. He just put it a bit of fuel line on and just
And that
slip
is
it on
what we have learned from experience modeler, eh?
Wing. So, the next thing is wing. Of course, it's here in the manual. The next step is the wing, and that's pretty much
it. Yeah, and we will be almost to the end of this assembly.
Now, it is all labeled for you. ESC, aileron, flaps. These are LEDs. One already comes from the back. This is for the wing.
Now, all that you need, you have labeled here, and all these labels are also on the wings. Show us, Captain Blush. That you have all these labels on, so you must put the right label to the right label, and that's it. Eh?
That's it. You cannot mess this up. Now I will take the canopy off because of the cable.
So you will put the power supply in the front of the plane.
Yes,
it's like just this.
You don't need nothing. Now I usually put a wing like this.
I will grab it for you,
or maybe I'll just put it like this.
You will see how long cables you
it
have.
It will be a lot easier. So. The first thing I have grabbed is ESC. Now I will look in the. So this is ESC. You just take a look. White.
Of course, you must also plug it correct.
Yes.
You have the signal plus and minus.
Now, after I plug it, I always check it once more. Now this is this. Okay, the next one is flap. So I search for the flap. Go back. Look once again. Black to the black. White to the white. And that's it. Okay, next one.
Yeah, I love it already, Captain Blush.
Next one is aileron. Yes. You put this in.
Is this a LED light? Don't tell me.
Where?
On the top.
Yeah, this is LED.
Yeah.
This is.
I didn't know this.
I told you.
I know there were here at the side and the front.
I told you there is a cable going from the back.
Hey, salute E-Flight Quick for this. Hey, because in this time that you have so much electronics available, it is so great that they already put the lights on, because the planes with the lights are so much sexier, right?
Yes. Now, the next thing is, the last thing is the LEDs. Now, you can plug them in if you want, if you don't want, you don't need to. Now, this is the last one.
Yeah, of course we will put the LEDs.
Now, I will snugly pull it to the front.
And now you have here two, or how do you call this? That must fit in the front.
Yes.
No, and just, of course, check.
Just push a little bit in.
So you will see that it will close sexy. Check the cables. Like Don't mess something.
Like this.
Oh.
That's it. Just take a look from the sides if there is any cable sticking out.
Is it okay?
Yes, perfect.
And now you have the nylon screw.
Later on, you will maybe have to disassemble this again. You know why?
Why?
Because you never know if they have put leveled the rudder and the front wheel, if they have put it
Yeah.
Because by looking at this, it's pretty much close.
Well, because you have one servo for the back rudder and for the steering of the plane.
So maybe if later on we will have to, you just unscrew this and just, there is a bolt on the servo, and that's it.
You put the servo to neutral on the radio, and then just align the both surfaces, and that's it.
Yes.
Yeah, no. This is it, or what, Captain Blush?
Just the only thing left is the wing supports. Now,
of course,
we will not put on the props until we will bind the plane with the with the radio.
Well, this is something viewers remember. Remember always, don't bind your planes with the prop on, just in case that something happens and you save your fingers.
We see on Facebook many pictures okay. of mishaps, and I already had some mishaps maybe about 4 years ago with a storage plane.
Yeah, I also had. Oh, I remember that one.
It bit me quite.
And I was bitten last year on my stomach.
Yes.
With the Messerschmitt, because I forgot to take the prop off, eh?
No.
Aha, one support.
You just.
Ah, you see here.
You just, there's nothing to do. You just put this in the.
You have left or right? Does it say something on?
No,
nothing.
They're the same.
They're the same. You have here the small slot.
Look,
on.
They're the same. Now.
You have here the small slot under the wing.
I'll just take a sneak peek. Yeah, that's it. Where's the slot? I can't
under
see.
The, yeah,
I can't
yeah.
see from here.
Yeah, but.
Wait.
Turn it to you. Turn it like this. Do you see it?
Here.
Let's see.
Let me put inside.
Hey, salute this quick, V-Flight. I mean, when have you seen the more simple support for the wings?
Now look at this.
There is always some R clip and some bolts and I don't know what. I
look
mean,
at this.
This is the best.
Film this.
Look.
Inside.
Oh, Captain Blush, I mean, this
felt
hey,
so.
But look at this, eh? Hey, it fits to a micromillimeter. And that's it, eh?
We can now remove this stand.
Put it down. Show me once the plane.
The plane.
I mean, look at this, viewers, eh? The first look.
I think that we will have to disassemble it again.
Why?
Because the front.
Yeah, we will see.
No, it's okay.
Is it?
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah, because you know, on the ultimate plane, the plane was already set perfect when I have binded to the radio. It was all no trimming needed. But one thing you have forgotten, Captain Blush.
What?
The back fins. Yeah. Show now, this also.
Now when we have assembled all this together, now you just look at this.
I will show close.
There are some teeth here that go.
In the foam.
Now I just push them inside, push them all the way down, and
that's it.
It just makes a little snapping sound.
Hey.
And that's it.
Hey, with this stabilization
it's
and the fins.
Now, the only thing, look, you were left with some screws, but that is for the.
Yeah, for the.
There floats. Are no extra screws, but these are for the floats. Because actually on the floats you will use four, eight, at least eight more, and some from the landing gear, so you will have to save these screws.
This is amazing, Captain Blush. Now of course you will save them.
Yes, I will put them in this bag right away, because
and we will put that bag in a bigger bag, put it in this one, Captain Blush, because you don't want to lose the screws.
No, you just...
Put them inside, we won't use them, because by this point, we won't use the floats.
Now, you will not need these tools anymore.
Just leave it to the side.
You will need a screwdriver for the spinner, but the next thing that you will need is an 8mm wrench, which we will use later on. Robert will first bind the transmitter.
Yeah, we will now bind it and see.
Yes, bind plug here.
Now, bind plug, leave it there, and that's it, eh?
I'll put this here.
Uh-huh. Put the radio, and you can also, I will take it.
I will bring the battery.
Because, of course, viewers, with this, we will also use the brand new smart 3200 free cell batteries, which I hope will give me the perfect CG. And now you can fly this from 2200 to
3200.
But I will use, of course, the bigger one, so I will get more flying time.
Now it's your turn.
Well, Captain Blush, come here and grab the camera.
Just don't press any buttons.
Yeah, this is
accidentally. Oh, why is your arm so hot, eh? It feels 100 degrees, eh?
Yeah, hot. We are filming the foam plane, so that means, that I'm all excited all over again, eh? Viewers, salute! Captain Blush has already assembled this plane, beautiful and sexy.
Which was 15 minutes?
Now you have seen that
with slow assembly. Yeah, this was the slow assembly of 15 minutes, but we can tell you that this was the 15 minutes of pure fun. And this is such a joy to assemble. Believe me, when you will have a plane like this, the assembly is as good as the maiden flight and the flights later. Because yes, like I said, at this point, you get familiar with the plane, you make a bond with it, and it will be your best friend on the runway. Yes. So this is it. Now, of course, like I have said, we will use today again the MX-6 radio, which we have proven on the previous video. We have done the maiden flight with the ultimate plane that it works perfectly.
Yes.
All that you need, you have on. And of course, we will use the option, the opportunity that we already have inside the settings for this plane. Now you can set them manually on any other radio. Of course, you can also bind this plane by without the receiver, and you can put whatever you want inside. But since I'm the Spectrum lover, which I admit, I will use today the beautiful sexy MX-6 radio, yes, which is good enough for the beginner pilots.
No,
so this is
no it. Start.
I will start it on.
Don't delay nothing more.
We don't want the video to be too long.
Well, it's already past 20 minutes, so...
Yeah. Now, of course, you have here the Ultimate 3D, which we were flying the last time, and now I will go here, press this button.
Press,
and then you go to the system setup. Confirm. Now, at this point, I will say it again. Whenever you will go in the system setup, you will lose the signal from the radio. Look, when I will push yes... I was waiting too long. Yes, do you see this?
Yes.
I don't have the signal anymore. So if I had the plane now stuck the battery inside, the plane can go crazy. So I will go now here to model select. We will put another model. Go here, the type of the model. I will choose, you have the normal, the helicopter, the sailplane. You have the quads, but you have also the bind and fly version.
Yes.
And in here, it is already the this plane that we need. Put create. And now it will take us to this file. And we will go down to the E-Flight. E-Flight.
Twin Otter.
Twin Otter. Select. Go to Twin Otter. Select. Import. Wait.
It's so easy.
And now you have Twin Otter already inside. Now always it will take you, it will always give you the 5 minutes of flying time, which I will of course leave, but I will right now I will check
what
they have done on the knobs, because they usually put also the sound on, so we will hear if it is the same as it was on the Ultimate. It was.
No, it's not smart.
Ah.
Yes.
Ah, do you see this? Yes. Yeah, but we must check, because it's so interesting, viewers. And this is interesting, eh? Because the E-Flight Ultimate has inside the smart receiver and the smart ESC. So when we have binded this to the plane, the old knobs had the sound already on.
Yes.
So now we will bind this, and with the bindings later, we will see what we have here. We will see on what knob is something. Yes. Now you can also go inside here and check in the channel assignments. You will see there what is what. But now we will just bind this. Of course, I will open this.
Yes, you will use the bind plug.
Now I will have, and you already have here that it says what you have to do. I will say it once more, but what's with this? It doesn't stay like this. I will put it here, the battery, like this. I will tell it to you. You must go in the system setup again, which I will go right now. Check this out. Go in the system setup. Yes, go. Now we already have this plane assigned. We have the settings for this plane. Go in bind and then go here and wait. And now if you want to bind in the safe select, you must put in the bind plug, put in the battery, and once you hear one beep,
be prepared.
Right after that, you must unplug the bind plug. Grab it for me so I won't be too late. Are you ready?
Yes.
Like this. And now I will go around 3 meters away from the plane and bind it.
Aha. Yes. Bind complete.
And that's it, eh? The plane is bind like it should be.
Yes.
Now, one thing that I will do, I will show you this.
The voice.
Put it you go back. Here, push this return button, and I will put it to 85.
Volume 85.
So we will hear it what it does, and now I will plug it back in, and we will just...
Now maybe, hey, maybe now the buttons are assigned. Because you have bind into the plane. Try it now.
No, you still have nothing here. Because it's not smart. Uh-huh. Now you can set yourself later. I will show you where you set yourself the sound on the switch. It's so easy. You just add a new sound and that's it. Now I have said that we will check now. We will check how the plane is binded and what we have on what.
Like this.
Like this. Now you have seen that it has gone twice around the plane, so that means that we have bind this in the safe select. Yes. Hey, look at the lights, eh? Huh?
They're pretty strong, eh?
Hey, pretty sexy, do you see this, eh?
Are these the same from here?
And look how beautifully already it is. I have just bind the plane.
Hey, look at this, eh? Hey, look at this.
It's all leveled.
Green LED, green motor, so you know where to put it on.
Yeah, but look how good it looks.
Now try
now, of course, later you will check if you have all aligned, if all is okay, or maybe if you will need some trimming. Now I already see, I don't think.
Front wheel?
The front wheel
yeah,
is
but
not
look,
exactly, do you see this thing? Yeah, not, nah. I will, but who cares
we will
about
do
that?
It later, not
you
now.
You go later in the sub-trim and you trim the plane. I will just check now how it works. Aerons! Do you see this?
Yes.
The elevator, uh-huh. And of course the rudder, and because it is already all set, you don't have to reverse nothing. It
yes,
all works
it's all prepared for you.
Now, let's see where are the flaps. Usually they are on this knob, and they are even slowed down. Do you see this, eh?
Yeah.
Do you see this, eh? Now, I must just check the throttle, and I must check where is the, usually they put this switch for the throttle cut. Ah, do you see this?
Yes.
And now I will set the 7th channel on something. Because if we check it right now, I think that at this point, do you see this?
Uh-huh.
We have the safe select all the time on. I will see if maybe they have chosen already some knob, but I don't think so. No. You must set yourself a knob. I will just see on which one are the low rates and the high rates. If it is the same as it was on the last plane. Because on the last plane, on the Ultimate, I was using the 7th channel for the reverse, eh? So this is it. I will see the ailerons. Where are the low rates? Ah, look at this, eh? Do you see this?
Is it all set in one knob?
Do you see this? I mean, this one is another. Because the Ultimate has the low rates on 3 buttons, and this one already has the all travels, do you see this? On 1 button.
Mm-hmm.
Now that is why you must check, because every plane is set different. So I just wonder, but we have seen that it is not, that the safe is still not selected. It is not, it must not be, so we will use, I will now go, look at this. I will go here. Wait, here, and I will see the 7th channel, which knob is pushing this one. The AUX 2, we will put the AUX 2, I must choose one knob, which one should we take? This one is already taken. This one are the flaps.
Yeah, you must choose one.
Maybe we can choose the gear. I will try to choose the gear this time because we don't have the landing gear to use, eh?
Yes.
I will unplug this, like this, and I will go.
I will go in the system. System setup. Yes. Channel assignment. We will see the gear, the flap. Aha, you can see here that it is inhibited. We will put this one. Aha, inhibited. We will put this one on, let's say, on the B, because we don't have the B, nothing. On the B, and that's it. Now I will go out like this. And I will plug it in again.
Put the battery in.
Let it go around. So this is it?
Yes.
And now I will push the sticks down and inside towards the inside of this and toggle this knob 5 times. We will see now if this will work.
Now
I will plug it again.
Plug it back in.
If not, we will choose a different knob. So now we have like this. Now we have the safe, and now let's try.
Do it again.
I will have to do it again. We must get.
No, you don't need to. Why did you unplug it again?
I will have to check here. Yeah, but it is the house one. It should be. It is the same.
Yeah, maybe you should do it twice like you did last time.
I don't know. It is on the right stick. I have it here. I will try once more.
Wait. Now it will check the surfaces.
Like this.
And this.
And go out from this.
No, do it again.
I will try again, like this.
Yes.
Inside, all the way down, 5 times.
Do it again. Maybe just need like this, yes.
No, it can't be again. I will try and plug it and plug it again.
If not, we will check that and we will tell you.
Yeah, but I was now.
On the main flight.
This must be something. I was binding it correctly. Is it?
Yes.
And now we have it, let's see. Like this. It's not working. Wait.
You can do this next time.
Wait,
on the maiden flight.
Yeah, to the bottom of this, you can film the plane in the meanwhile.
This will be 1 hour video.
Yeah, of course it will not be.
It's 35 much. Minutes already.
Channel assignments, gear. Yeah, gear. Maybe we will use. Maybe we will use. Let's try, okay. Just for fun, I will use gear. I will go back. Let's check here. Gear. This will not work, eh? Let's try. Maybe if I will use the gear, if it will work because we don't have the landing gear, I will plug it in once more. Maybe we should do the bind procedure again or what?
You will do it next time.
And this is interesting, eh? Maybe they have something in the instruction manual, Captain Blush, because on the last time, do you know that it wasn't the seventh channel was using for the reverse throttle?
Yes.
I will try this once more to put like this, now this one. I don't hear nothing.
No, it didn't make any sound, but you will show this next time.
Safe. And the safe is on.
You need to read the manual, no?
So this is it, my friend, say.
Yes.
I mean, it is bind in the safe mode, but of course, I will tell you on the maiden flight what I have done. Of course, that is why you have the instruction manual. I didn't check nothing, but if you want to bind in the safe select, you must put in the bind plug. After one beep, you take it out and then you will have the plane in the safe select. I mean,
yes.
What, maybe we will film the second video like we did with the Ultimate. Because it was the same,
It was the same guessing on that plane, to guess how to set that
shape. You will take your time and read the manual, and then we will set it.
So that's it.
Yes.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with the beautiful and sexy assembly of the Twin Otter, the beautiful plane, which still had to be set in the safe select on the knob, And this is something, So this is it,
Yes.
I can't wait to go on the runway with this. Thanks for your support, for stopping by, and just expect more pretty soon. And of course, on the next video, we will put back on the props, Not right now, So this is it. The captain must get quick! Because I must check quick what is this,